don't mean it, I'm sure.
I do. There's no reason for you to be mad at your boy.
Why do you have to be so dismissal, Uncle? You're rich enough.
Ah, I'm back.
Don't be cross, Uncle.
Well, what else can I pay when I'm in such a world of fools as this? Merry Christmas. How to find Merry Christmas? What is Christmas time? A time for finding yourself a year old and not one hour rich. A time for buying gifts without money. I can work my lips. Every idiot with the words Merry Christmas on his lips should be boiled with his own pudding and buried as a steak of pie in his heart.
Oh.
That's you. You keep Christmas in your own way, let me keep it in mine.
Keep it, but you don't keep it.
Well, keep it alone. Much good may it do you. Much good as it ever done.
I'll go in there and put a scrap of gold in my pocket. I'll say God bless it.
One more sound from you and you lose Christmas by keeping your situation. You're quite a harvest. You're quite a powerful speaker, sir. I want you to go on the Parliament.
Why do you have to be so dismissive, Uncle? Come down with us tomorrow.
Good afternoon.
I want nothing from you. I ask nothing from you. Why can't I with your friends?
Good afternoon.
Merry Christmas and a happy new
year. Good afternoon. That's not fair. My clerk for 15 shillings a week. A wife and children talking about a Merry Christmas.
Scrooge and Marley's, I believe. So you got the pleasure to addressing Mr. Scrooge and Mr. Marley.
Miss Marley's been dead for 7 years. He died 7 years ago. Just very much.
We have no doubt that Raleigh will represent my surviving partner.
Well, this festive season of the year, Mr. Scrooge, we would like to make some changes as normally desired for the poor who suffer greatly at this present time. Many thousands without wants or necessities, hundreds of thousands without needs of comfort, sir.
Are they the debtors' prisons? No union workhouse? Are they not in operation?
They are, still. I wish they were not.
Both are very easy, sir.
Well, at this time, Mr. Scrooge, we are raising funds to feed the poor. One about some food, drink, and some clothes.
We chose this time of always getting filled. What shall I put you down for?
Nothing.
Oh, you wish to remain anonymous.
I wish to be let alone. I do not make myself merry at Christmas. My heart's afford to make either of you merry. I have to support the establishments I have mentioned. They cost enough. And those who are bad off must go there.
Many can't go there. Many would rather die.
They'd rather die than to do it to decrease the surplus population.
Good afternoon.
War distractions.
You're too cheap for that, Ebenezer.
Mind your tongue. Or mind the street, whichever you feel more warm.
I find it to be more warmer in the streets than in here.
We'll have to see about that, my friend.
If quite convenient, sir.
It's not convenient and it's not fair. But it's not half a crap. Would you find yourself ill-used, wouldn't you? Yes, you don't find me ill-used. My pay lays wages for no work.
It's only once a year, Scrooge.
A poor excuse for picking your man's pocket down on the 25th of December. Though I suppose you must have the whole day. All early the next morning.
Let any man swing to me and thank me. How it happened that Scrooge,
outside of it. Dreadful horror of people. We choose this time and want as keenly felt indeed. Fear, priests, wretch, horror, parasites. I hate them all. I hate them all. Merry Christmas. Ha! Well, always.
Charity was all my business, but I'm the one. You've always been a good friend to me, Jacob.
I have nothing else to give you. The time is drawing near. You will be haunted by three spirits.
I think I've run out.
The first will approach you when the bell tolls once. The second, the next night at the same hour. And the third, when the clock strikes 12 and ceases to vibrate.
Good to have another once in that energy.
I have nothing else to give to you. Look at me no more. And remember what has passed between us.
I'm so tired of kissing you. I'm going to get these holes like that.
You're quite a winner, little friend.
Always a winner. But she had a good arm.
So she had.
Yeah, she died. And had two.
One child.
Two, your nephew.
Yes.
What's the matter?
No, she's like to have a word with my brother about how that's all.
Let us see another Christmas.
Why, so Fezziwig, bless his heart. Fezziwig alive again! Ah! How about it,
Ben? You know, I can do a joke one day.
I bet you could. A small matter makes these silly little folks so full of gratitude.
So small.
Yeah.
Spirit, tell me, I see a vacant space by the poor chimney, and a crutch unattended. If the spirit remains unaltered, the child shall die.
Oh, no, kind spirit. Come, you'll be spared.
Who are you to say what will die and who will die?
There was nothing to calm our fears. There were not a handsome family. There were not well dressed. Their sheets were inclined to let the water and snow in, and their clothes were dripping. But they were happy, grateful, blessed with one another, and contented with the house. It was a great surprise to Scrooge, while listening to the moaning of the wind, to hear a hearty laugh. It was a much greater surprise to Scrooge to recognize it as his own nephew's voice.
He said Christopher was a humbug. As I live, he believed it too.
That's for shame for him, Fred.
He's a comical old fellow, and that's the truth. His offenses would carry out their own punishment, and I have nothing to say against him.
Now, Fred, didn't you tell me that your uncle was a very, very rich man? At least that's what I thought you said.
I spare his life so short.
My time is short here. Aha! Look at here.
They were a boy and a girl. Meager, ragged, scowling, wolfish. Where graceful youth should have filled out their features, instead were pinched and twisted as with age. Where angels might have sat and grown, devils lurked and flared out menacing. No change, no degradation, no perversion of humanity in any grade. Through all the mysteries of life, has monsters held their marble and dread.
Spirits, are they yours?
No, they are man's. The boy is ignorance and the girl is want. Beware of them both, but I see written over the boy, do.
Have they no refuge or resources?
Are there no prisons? Are there no workhouses?
No. I will not say.
Lonely spaces for outcasts.
what happened in time before us, is that so, Spirit? Oh, great Spirit of the future. I fear you more than any specter I have seen. But as I know, your purpose is to do me good. And as I wish to be a different man from what I was, I will bear your company and do the thing you want. Will you not speak to me? Are you going that way?
Thank you. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a
part of the community. Thank you. misses me so much. You know, Lisa knows the type of person likes to be in the background and whatever you ask me to do, I'll just go on and do it. You know, the holidays are kind of bittersweet for me. About 2 years ago, I lost my brother and my sister, you know, and, you know, I think that, well, I'm just going to say it, a lot of things happen for a reason. And this is a great, wonderful distraction, a positive distraction. You know, y'all know I love y'all. I thank you so much for this. I'm just excited about the future, you know, in this adventure that we started. I know y'all have my back. This is not the end. This is just the beginning. There are going to be, theater classes being offered in the spring. And so, you know, spread the word about them. You want to build the theater program. But I was going to say thank you, OJ, in the back. This young man came all the way from Raleigh, North Carolina, to do our sound. And he's used to working in huge coliseums and doing sound for some pretty big names. And then there